Bizarre as this may seem, after hundreds of years of balance and respect...
What's all this hippie talk about antioxidants? So this stuff actually helps us with everything.
This is where I heal my hurt. It's in natural grace, or watching young life shape. It's in minor keys, solutions and remedies. Enemies becoming friends.
I don't know if it's hippie talk, but yeah,
they think it is, and I used to think it was 5 years ago. Yeah. If I'd looked at myself now, and I've said this a million times, I would have pointed at myself and said, "You're a hippie." Yeah?
Sure.
We're here with Nadine Artemis, and she's been on stage speaking about sun, about sunscreens, and a whole host of other stuff. And through Anna Blanca, my entourage, I put my entourage as Sage, we've nabbed her, taken her upstairs and captured you. And I just want to ask you some questions.
Yeah.
And I want you to just share as much as you can share. There are people at home right now, even myself like 12 months ago, would be putting on sunscreen factor 30. Mm. And thinking, well, I have to wear sunscreen.
Well, sunscreen is problematic for a number of reasons. And it's actually easier for our body to process getting burned than it is for our DNA to handle processing the cell damage from being in the sun with sunscreen.
Let's say that again. So it's easier
for our DNA to get sunburned than it is for our DNA to process being in the sun with sunscreen.
Okay.
Because there's so much going on with sunscreen. It's chemical laden, and the ingredients are very free radical generating. One of the main ingredients right now is oxybenzene.
I mean,
different ones go in and out, and Europe actually has tougher regulations on ingredients.
I love when you point at me and say, you're a European.
They have some better regulations, but still, they're like, oops, we're not going to use that one anymore. Okay, now we're going to use this one. And benzone is a free radical generator, a really potent one, and it's actually non-carcinogenic until it's exposed to sunlight.
That's ridiculous.
It's so ridiculous.
Absolutely ridiculous.
And that's like the main active ingredient. Then there's all the other ingredients, like just, you know, parabens.
Yeah.
Petroleum derivatives and all that. So we're accumulating those chemicals into our lipid layers, our fat, and that can be xenoestrogenic, which is gender bending stuff, and then changing our DNA structure, mutating cells. Because that's what. So when we're in the sun with sunscreen, we're altering the innate intelligence of our cells.
Yeah.
What we're also doing is we're blocking the UVB rays. Those are the ones that burn. So that kind of makes sense from a sunscreen perspective, but
we're
blocking UVB, and that's what's creating vitamin D.
Yeah, okay.
And what
vitamin D is,
and we want the vitamin D, because we have, in North America, there's over 75% of adults are totally deficient in vitamin D.
Okay.
And I imagine England's pretty on par.
Yeah, we don't have much sun, so.
I know, in the north too. And then what it does is also separating UVA and UVB, and it's allowing the penetration of UVA. And current studies are showing that the UVA is damaging on its own to the skin.
Okay.
So that's for starters.
So it's just messing with us. It's just
messing
it's. So what should we be using on our skin? Should we be using anything?
You can use so many plant oils, because plant oils offer protection to the plant.
Yeah,
and they also offer protection to us. So there's many plant oils that can extend our time in the sun and harmonize us with the sun. SPF can only be officially used with synthetic sunscreen ingredients.
Okay, so if it says SPF, steer clear.
Yes, but what I want to say is, like, plants do in a way offer an SPF, but you could never technically say, like, olive oil SPF 8. But in a way, that's sort of what it does do. So virgin coconut oil, jojoba.
I use that all over the time.
Yeah, it's so great. And then olive oil. Jojoba is a desert plant. And
okay,
it's
so
awesome,
it's going to be in the sun.
It's so great.
So jojoba, olive oil,
yeah.
Extra virgin, pressed, of course.
The best.
And,
we don't have to go into the olive oil issues,
no,
but there's a lot.
Imagine how far we can go with this conversation.
Also, we can create an internal sunscreen.
Okay.
Oh, there's so much to talk about. We can create an internal sunscreen by eating properly and eating antioxidant-rich foods. And what we put in our bodies directly affects our relationship with the sun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So give us a list of three or four things to put on our skin for when we go in the sun.
So we can do the olive oil, coconut, jojoba. I love, of course, putting essential oils in there.
Yep.
Well, you know what? It's not even about the wires. It's just about bras in general.
Yeah.
And they create lymphedema in our breasts. And so the main key to look at when you're taking off your bra at night is to see if you have red marks.
So if I have red marks?
Yeah, anywhere. And if you do, then you need a whole new different bra thing. So you want to go as much without one or with something just really gentle, like an organic cotton with like 2% lycra.
Organic cotton with about 2% lycra.
Yes, because they're not allowing the lymph system to flow.
Bizarre as this may seem, after hundreds of years of balance and respect for the creative process, there's been an explosion in a new approach by the law to these efforts and expressions of creativity. This is my favorite example.
What's all this hippie talk about antioxidants? So this sort of actually helps us with everything.